Hello friends, welcome to Simply Chemistry. In the previous videos about NMR, you have seen how to predict the number of NMR signals for a given molecule and the factors affecting the chemical shift values of the NMR signals. In this video, we are going to see one more important aspect about NMR, the spin-spin coupling and the coupling constant. And also we are going to see in what way they are very helpful to elucidate a structure of a molecule. So let us get started with what we know. So basically, NMR works on the electron density, which is related to the chemical environment. Which is related to the signals. We already know it. Spin-spin coupling takes place only when there is difference in the chemical environment. First, let us see an example where no spin-spin coupling takes place. So let us say this example, ethane. So we know that it gives only one proton NMR signal. And we could see that both of them are same chemical environment. So in this kind of a cases, the coupling of the signals between these proton will not happen. No spin-spin coupling because the chemical environment is same. No spin-spin coupling. Whereas, let's see an example in case of propane. So in this case, we get two proton NMR signals. So we know that these two are of similar nature, so A type, and this is of a different type, B type. So what happens is that the magnetic moment of A proton couple with the magnetic moment HB proton. So due to this coupling, the lines obtained for these protons, normally we will get two single lines, the expected ones. So because of this spin-spin coupling, this line, single lines will be split further. The formula to calculate the number of lines is given by n plus 1, where n is nothing but the corresponding number of adjacent protons. So if you see for this protons, that is these three protons, the adjacent protons are these. So the number of adjacent protons in this case is 2. So the lines obtained for this HA protons will be split into 2 plus 1, that will become 3 lines. We call that as a triplet. So you could see that these lines will be split into 3 lines like this. Similarly, in case of HB protons, we see like there are 2 adjacent protons. We see that the total amounts to 6 protons. So 3 in this case and 3 in the other case. So totally 6 plus 1 lines. So that's going to be totally of 7 lines. We call that as a multiplet. We generally represent it by M. So this next line is split into 7. And the intensity of the each line follows the Pascal's triangle. We know that Pascal triangle value, that's all. So the intensity of the lines follows the Pascal's triangles and so on. So we'll see a few more examples
let's see here the case of CH2 double bond CH single bond C.
So in this case you could see there are two proton NMR signals. So we have HA type and H beta. So because of the presence of HB or the spin-spin coupling of HB with HA, the signals are split into 1 plus 1. So this single line, it's going to be split into two lines. We call that as a doublet. The distance between these lines is what we call it as the coupling constant J, which is given in terms of Hertz. So I repeat again, due to the coupling of HB with HA protons, the single line obtained for HA is split into two. We get the lines like this, and the distance between these peaks is what we call it as the coupling constant J, and it is generally given in terms of Hertz. So in case of, there are different types of coupling can happen, mostly in case of a geminal coupling can happen, but the J value is of 0 to 3 Hertz, kind of very less, maybe you may not see the difference at all. In case of vicinal coupling, I'll show you example in case of geminal and vicinal what it mean by. So generally it is greater than 3, the J value is generally greater than 3 Hertz. Of the vicinal coupling, the most important factor is the cis coupling. Cis coupling, the J value is less than 10 Hertz, whereas the trans coupling, J value is greater than 10 Hertz. Geminal coupling is nothing but the coupling between the hydrogens in the same, attached to the same carbon atom. This is possible in some cases where we talk about some protons are not magnetically equivalent. Like in this case, you see that double bond attached, one side it is with chlorine, the other side it is with hydrogen. So this hydrogen is kind of close with this hydrogen, but far away from the chlorine, whereas this hydrogen is of different sort. So in this kind of a case, the geminal coupling can happen, but the value will be same. Vicinal coupling is coupling between this proton and proton attached to a next carbon atom. The coupling between these two is, we generally call it as the vicinal coupling. I hope you understand. Let us see few more examples. So we'll see in case of benzene or a monosubstituted benzene. Let us take this as an example. So some substitution has taken place. If there is a substitution, we know like we're going to get three different types of signals. So if you go for the spin-spin coupling for HA, it has only one adjacent proton and it's going to be a doublet, whereas this one, these two protons are not of same chemical nature. So what we will do is that we will use a formula, we call it as Na plus Nb plus 1. When a proton, it attaches to two different types of, or surrounded by two different types of chemical environmental protons, then we use this formula. In this case, 1 and 1. So we'll have 2 into 2. So expected is quartet, but may not be seeing quartet in reality. For this one, there are two adjacent protons. This is going to be a triplet, as it's a quartet, and this is going to be a triplet. So let us see some more disubstituted benzenes.
there you will find something interesting. So let us try with the ortho disubstituted benzene. So this is going to give us two proton NMR signals, 22 type. So this again is going to be HA and HB. So if you look into this, this is going to be a doublet. This is also going to be a doublet. This is going to be a doublet. This is going to be a doublet. So let us try with a meta substituted, disubstituted benzene. You could see here. So this is going to give us three signals. HA, this is going to be HB, and this is also going to be HB type. And this is going to be HC. So there is no adjacent proton in this case, so there is no possibility for spin-spin coupling. So this is going to be a singlet, and this, there is only one adjacent proton. This is going to be a doublet, and this is going to be a triplet because there are two adjacent proton. As usual, this is going to be a doublet. So we'll see also see for the para disubstituted. So what would be the number of signals, proton NMR signals in this case? We get only one signal because all the hydrogens are equivalent in this case. So all of them will be giving only one single line, that's singlet. What is the compare, if you compare between these disubstituted benzenes, what is the speciality for the para is that this molecule has a center of symmetry or the inversion center. There is a center of symmetry in this molecule. I hope you know what is center of symmetry. So you start from one end, you travel to the center of the molecule, you travel the same distance opposite. If you find the same molecule or same atom or same chemical environment, we call then the molecule as center of symmetry. So you can have this in mind, higher symmetry. So obviously, a lower number of signals. So of the three, like this gives us two signals, this is one signal, whereas this gives us only one signal. So I hope you understand. So let's see a few more examples. So let us see with the methanol. So from the diagram, it's clear that it's going to give us two signals. So this is going to be HA and this is going to be HB. If we talk about the spin-spin splitting pattern for in this case, we may think it will give you a doublet because there is one adjacent proton, but actually in reality, it is actually a singlet. The reason why is the nucleus spin of oxygen, I equals zero for oxygen. So hence, it will not allow the coupling to happen, it will not allow the coupling to pass by. Hence actually, we get two singlets, rather a doublet and a quartet. This is the reason. This may ask you a question that even C6-12, I equals zero, but 1 in 100 C or carbon or C13, where C13 high is equal to half. So based on this abundance, there is a chance for coupling can happen in the rest of the cases, whereas in this case the coupling may not happen. The reason why is oxygen nucleus spin is zero. Let's see one more example to find out the number of signals and the spin-spin splitting pattern in case of butane. So in this case you could see that there are two types of hydrogen. We have a HA type, HA, and these two are going to be HB type. So there are totally two proton NMR signals, So you could see that there is only two adjacent protons, so this is going to be, the signals are going to be a triplet. Whereas in this case, you could see that though we have adjacent protons, these two protons are of similar chemical environment. So this can couple only with this proton. So this will become 3 plus 1 and it's going to be a quartet. Likewise, this can couple only with this. So this is going to be a quartet and this is going to be a triplet. So I hope you understand the coupling can happen only when there is difference in the chemical environment. If the chemical environment is same, the protons will not undergo the coupling value. I give you some practice problems where I just want you to find out the number of signals and the splitting pattern. So first we'll see how we will. So let us see this example. We'll have a bromine. Try with naphthalene. So we'll try out with anthracene. And with n-pentane. So I just want you to find the number of signals, proton NMR signals, and their splitting pattern. So we already know this. There will be three signals. We have H8I. These two will be of HB. This is going to be a HC type. This is going to be a singlet. This is going to be a doublet. And this is going to be a triplet. And this is going to be also a doublet. So in this case, how many signals we will get? We will get only two signals. We will have a HA type and a B type. The rest of them, because this molecule is also having some sort of symmetry. I'm just making the molecule into four quadrant. All these quadrants are kind of similar to this one. So there are only two proton NMR signals. So we have only adjacent proton 1-1, so this is going to be a doublet, and this also going to be a doublet. So in this case, again, I will see that this molecule as the top half is similar to that of the bottom half, and also we can even cut into this. So we have one proton here, so this is going to be HA type, this is going to be HB type, and we're going to have HC type. So we have totally three proton NMR signals. So the splitting pattern nature will be, this is going to be a singlet because there is no adjacent protons. We have a carbon, likewise there is no adjacent proton in this case. So again, this is going to be a doublet and this is going to be a doublet. Like it's the same case of nothing. The last one again, this is going to be of three proton NMR signals. So we will go to the spin, we will get three signals. So there is only two adjacent protons, so this is going to be a triplet. For this case, we have two different type of things, so this is going to be 3 plus 1 into 2 plus 1, so it's going to be a multiplet. So anything beyond 5, we say it as a multiplet. But this one, this is going to be like 4 plus 1, it's going to be a 5 lines. We call it as quintet. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I request, learning NMR is very simple. If you could watch all the three videos, almost explains the basic requirement to solve simple molecules.
If you bygard certain NMR value, it will be easy for you to solve for the competitive exams. Thank you once again.